while legislation takes quite a long time to change, and we know this, and there may be a lot of need and a lot of lobbying to do that, as you've expressed many times in the past, we have immediate needs that we need to fulfill. And this actual tech platform will give you the power to, as mentioned before, upload your catalogs of music, have it audio fingerprinted. We will, at 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, be monitoring every single broadcaster in Trinidad and Tobago to ensure that we know every single time your song plays. You will have real-time access to every bit of your song information, every radio station it played at, the exact time that it played at, so you can not only have and build your repertoire as an independent artist and an entrepreneur, but also perhaps hold a CMO accountable. We'll be working with the CMOs alongside this thing and say, okay, so I have these amounts of radio plays, you know, this is what is happening. Can you tell me, can you help me out? You know, we need to be able to actually build these data and statistics as well. A lot of the calls have been that why isn't Trinidad and Tobago represented in terms of the Billboard charting? Why don't we have soca there and calypso there? Why isn't it that we have to be logged under world music or under reggae music? The reasons are numerous, but what it comes down to is that Billboard works with a simple, or rather a complex algorithm, but a simple system. In other words, if this algorithm doesn't exist within your territory, you can't begin to engage them. And this algorithm means that you have to track the radio charts that are happening, your downloads, your streams, your music, your online presence, the amount of albums you sell both physically and digitally. You need to be able to put this algorithm together, Seismen, the company internationally that usually does this, and be able to say, okay, we have this data, we've transparently gathered it for everything that's happening so that we can now fully chart our music, and therefore we have a reason to go and lobby to Billboard and say, we want to have place, an individual place for soca and calypso and chutney, let's say, on your charts. But we can't do that without putting these systems in place first, and it begins with the transparent monitoring of music and radio in order to ensure that we know how much our artists are playing and how much they need to be playing, even in the drive towards increasing local content on our airwaves.